Hey folks, check it out. This is Lenovo's new Yoga Home 900, their impressively thin, giant 27-inch all-in-one tablet PC that we saw here at their event in San Francisco. So this guy weighs almost 16 pounds and is supported by this pretty hefty spring-loaded kickstand in the back. So you can use it with the kickstand, but it's actually really designed to be used flat on a surface like a table or a desk, and ideally by multiple people. So it folds down here. We were trying this out, and unfortunately we noticed some odd things right away. You can see there that automatic brightness control is pretty aggressive, and the screen actually gets really dim when it's kicking in. We also had a few problems with apps being unresponsive. I'm speeding stuff up here to make it a little less boring. So I couldn't make that one work, and tried to get into settings, and it went back to the music app. I was getting irritated enough by that brightness that I tried to find a way to turn off the automatic brightness when I encountered some menu items that weren't working at all. And finally I found over here, unfortunately that brightness slider was running backwards. I couldn't tell why that was working. I think the automatic brightness was messing it up. I thought I had it solved here, and I tried to go back to the home screen and check out some other apps which weren't really opening, and suddenly it opened the settings back up again, and then the brightness kicked in again and made everything too dim, menu items that wouldn't work. There we go, we got the brightness set, so we can actually use this thing. Took three or four clicks to get back to the home screen. And I decide here that I'm gonna try playing some Candy Crush, and once again, this is 3x speed, and that wouldn't load. I try to get this other app here. Nothing, it's not working, maybe it's not installed, I couldn't tell. We try to go home, and suddenly I'm back at Candy Crush, where they have an impressive 41-page privacy agreement. Lenovo talked up a lot their new launcher called Aura, which is designed to work with this big tabletop tablet. We couldn't actually find it in the app list. We had to search for it with Cortana. When we got it running, it's actually pretty cool. It spreads all your apps across these radial menus, so anyone sitting at any point around this tablet can open a menu and rotate it to face them, which is actually a pretty slick idea. So we're going to try some drawing here. We always loved crayons, so get the crayon program going, and unfortunately this had some problems too. So it's kind of misreading my touch input a little bit. It's off-centered and reversed, maybe? I was a little confused by this. I thought I was actually doing something wrong at first. This guy came over to give it a try, and he couldn't work at it either. Suddenly I was just rotating crayons no matter what I did. We tried to go home to back out of it. We couldn't really touch anything. Suddenly the entire thing just locked up for a while. And this guy actually had the really bright idea that if we tipped it up and reset its sensors that decide whether it's in tablet or PC mode, it might work. And hey, it did. And finally we can go and we can color in these delightful hobos, I guess. There's supposed to be a lot of drawing and productivity software. You know, Lenovo was talking about actual graphic design and things like that, taking advantage of this great big tablet real estate. We couldn't actually find those. We were trying to look. I'm a little curious how that would actually work too. This is only a 1080p screen, despite being 27 inches. And unfortunately, because you sit so close to it, the pixelation is actually more visible than I would really like on a screen this big. We were trying to find the drawing software in this. This is the Aura App Store, which they say is going to launch with more than 500 apps. And it looked like there was a decent selection, but we weren't really sure what we were looking for. One great thing, actually, we did finally manage to get this to load and launch up. This was the digital version of the board game Life. And the minute we got this running, people came down and sat and were excited to play, and we had folks looking over our shoulders. And this actually definitely attracted attention. Lenovo talks about the whole concept behind this tablet as people all playing or experiencing interactive media together, all on one device. And I think they might be conceptually onto something. This definitely caught people's attention. There is something nice about all sitting around something, all doing something together like this. I think there could definitely be a market for devices like this in the future. I'm just not sure if this device, with all the bugs we've seen, is the one that's going to be it.